Good morning and welcome to St. Ambrose. Our opening song today is number 558, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 558. Please stand.
I hear we have a new speaker system. So there'll be no more sleeping during my homily. May the Lord of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sinfulness and so prepare ourselves to celebrate this mystery. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered up at his right hand, we may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. This is what Isaiah, son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on the highest mountain and raised above the hills. All nations shall stream toward it. Many peoples shall come and say, "Come, let us climb the Lord's mountain to the house of the God of Jacob, that God may instruct us in God's ways and we may walk in God's paths." For from Zion shall go forth instruction and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and impose terms on many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. One nation shall not raise a sword against another, nor shall they train for war again. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you know the time. It is the hour now for you to awake from sleep, for our salvation is nearer now than when we first believed. The night is advanced, the day is at hand. Let us then throw off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves properly as in the day, not in orgies and drunkenness, not in promiscuity and lust, not in rivalry and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the desires of the flesh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his followers, "The days when you will await the coming of the Son of Man are very similar to the time of Noah, when people were awaiting what was coming. But they didn't really realize it, so they went about their business. They earned a living, they ate and drank, they celebrated, they were married, and they helped their children marry. Right up to the time that Noah went into the ark, they had no idea what they were facing. And then the rain came, and the floods came, and they were all flooded away and lost. It can be like that with the Son of Man. You have no idea when he is coming and what it will seem like. And it will be like those people waiting for the flood, not knowing what was happening. When the Son of Man comes, two men will be working in the field. One will be taken, the other will be left. And two women will be grinding grain at this stone grinding machine. And one will be taken and the other will be left. That is how it will be with the coming of the Son of Man. So make an effort to be prepared for that coming. I tell you, if there were a homeowner that knew that that men were going to break into his house this night and steal things, he would not go upstairs and go to bed. He would wait up all night to make sure that no one violated his own home. Then he would be ready for that. You don't know when the coming of man is going to come into your life, but be ready for it. Because he will touch you with new life, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the church, this feast of Advent is a time of expectation. Some good things are coming. Just like the Jews had to wait for centuries for the coming of the Messiah. But God is not through with any of us. And he is still coming to us. And the church's preparation for that is to just say, be aware of what's going on around you. See that God is coming into your life. And act accordingly. Years ago, I made a group retreat somewhere. I think it was in Detroit. And again, with these Jesuit people. And the retreat master, when I went to him individually, he said, you've got to just... let God come into your life. You've got to make room for God. And he said, it's almost like every morning when you're in the morning tomorrow when you wake up, think about this is the first day of creation. And you're walking into a new world where God is leading you. And he said, that's what it means to live one day at a time. And I said to him, amen, come on. You're telling me I gotta start my whole life all over again tomorrow morning? And he said, oh, no, no, it's different than that. I'm telling you, you've gotta do that every day for the rest of your life. That's what it means to say living one day at a time. Each day that we will be awaiting the touch of God. That retreat master had another comment that is quite unorthodox, but I've never forgotten it. He said, we don't understand our language. We think the word God is a noun. He said, I think the word God is a verb. God is doing something all the time. And we say that 30 billion light years ago, God created the universe. But it didn't just go like that. God is still creating the universe. It's an ongoing thing. And he said, God is creating your part in that universe. Each day God is creating Jimmy in here. Each day God is creating you and you and all of you individually in here. None of us are finished projects. We've all got a long ways to go to reach that level. So the church is saying, wake up. As you walk into life for the next few days, realize that you're walking into the creation of God. And you just need to be aware of that. Strikes me, all this talk about awareness is something that the Buddhists have a great emphasis on, even more than Catholics. The message of this Advent is, wake up and see what's going on around you. And if you're looking at that and seeing it well, you will be grateful and you will be joyful. I believe in one God.
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, begotten from the God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us recall the intentions for which we would pray.
For the family of God, may our God help us to build a culture of life in vigilant expectation of God's return. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders and an end to war and violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of travelers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and suffering, for all medical staff, and for caregivers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are poor and those who are alone during these holidays, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister diocese in Lodwar, Kenya, and our sister parish in Guatemala, and our St. Ambrose Parish family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, those in our Book of Intentions, and for those requesting our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Peg Diem and Dorette Canet families, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our Heavenly Father, we welcome you into our being. We accept your touch as you do that within us, and we glory in it, and we are grateful. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Our song during the preparation of the gifts is number 410, Lord of All Hopefulness, number 410.
Who gives
brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devotedly here below may gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise to which we now dare to hope. And so with all the host of heaven, we sing a hymn of your glory as without end, we acclaim. Sending down your spirit upon them so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister for you.
Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Ambrose, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 621, Bread of Life, number 621.
Our announcements. Thank you for your generous donations to the Diocesan Home Heating Assistance Program. This year, we are going to have a St. Ambrose Parish Family Christmas tree in the vestibule. Please bring in an ornament from your family. You can print your name on it and place it in the box in the vestibule to help us decorate this special tree for our Christmas celebrations. The box will remain in the vestibule until December 23rd. Thank you. The Food Lift and Plainwell Pines Giving Tree is up in the vestibule and will remain until Sunday, December 4th. Please take a tag or two to help them celebrate Christmas. Please return and place your unwrapped gift with the tag attached in the wrapped box next to the giving tree. The confirmation class of 2023 would like to invite you to donate to their warm winter clothes drive for Kalamazoo homeless residents. Please donate new gloves, socks, hats, and scarves. The drive will take place now through December 4th. Have a blessed week.
We shall now pray the prayer for spiritual renewal and vocations. Heart of Christ, renew your priests in your love. Help them devote themselves more deeply to building up your body, the church, so that we may all become one in your life and love. Let your Holy Spirit rekindle the fire of your love within our priests. Help them to set the world on fire through the faithful practice of their priestly ministry. May we support and encourage our priests with our prayer as they strive to be good, holy, compassionate, and inspiring pastors for us who are entrusted to their care. May we grow to be faithful and joyful witnesses to your presence in our world. May God bless and help all our families to encourage each other to respond to your invitation to follow me in our particular vocations. Help many more young men respond to your call to serve your church and priestly ministry for our diocese. Loving and merciful God, since the beginning of time, you have been making all things new. Call our world back to you. Deepen our faith, renew our priests, and guide our entire diocese, priests and people, through this life into the everlasting life of heaven. May we proclaim with all our hearts, you are my Lord and my God, as you renew us in your life-giving love, now and forever. Amen. So, just one more thing before the final prayer. As we have started this season of Grace of Advent, we have a nice resource to help us in our preparation. So we have this little book entitled Advent 2022, and we have copies at the vestibule by the table there. So as you walk out, please have a copy for yourself or two. And then we have the new missalettes, which run for 1 year. So what you got in your pews, we have about 60 extra. So if you need one for your home, please welcome. You have them at the table at the back there at the vestibule. Thank you very much. So we shall now arise and then we'll pray. William, come.
May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now as we walk amid pleasing passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is Rain Down, number 621, number 621.